If you could take a camcorder and a tape back in time some 45 years ago to this very spot, you might find a few changes. For example, this huge imposing structure behind me wasn't even here 45 years ago. The second largest building in Newfoundland wasn't even built until 1955. Or how about Lower 900 housing? Plenty of units here. These weren't erected until 1957. This brown, squishy marsh here in front of 900 housing was once known as 200 housing. Yes, a lot has changed. It's become a lot more hectic. In fact, the name has changed. 45 years ago, this side of Argentia was known as Fort McAndrew. It was a lot more hectic back then, but then again, there was a war on. Newfoundland Railway extended its fingers of tracks deep into the base, down through parts of the fitness trail. And the area in front of the club? Well, technically, it wasn't even named Argentia, Newfoundland. All that you see behind me was named, back then, Marquis, Newfoundland. That's right, Marquis Avenue is named for this small town. Two large buildings were down at the helipad, and the Morgan Star Pier, just recently torn down, played host to dozens of flea ships. Little homes for Newfoundlander fishermen still dotted this shoreline amidst the several barracks buildings where now grows only crabgrass. Fort McAndrew was commandeered by the Air Force in 1947, but was absorbed into the U.S. Naval Station Argentia in 1950. Although all Air Force influence left in 1955, a small contingent remained to man a radar station at Site Sam. The main road in Argentia was a dirt path back then. Nothing but trees and grass on either side. No pavilion, no parking lot. And as we travel up the hill, absolutely no 1000 housing. Now that wouldn't be built until 1955 and 57. Although a cemetery for the men who died in the Truxton Pollux disaster in St. Lawrence was built here, what was quaintly named as Boot Hill. Now this also begs the question, was in fact 1000 housing built on the remains of an old cemetery? Well, judge for yourself. In the 45 years since the U.S. military has occupied this site, there have been many more changes than just the name. Now, in future segments, we'll have a look at the CBQ and the club building and talk to a couple of people who remember those changes.